Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to do advanced text automations in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever run into a situation where you really wanted to do something more interesting with the text in ProPresenter 7, maybe you've got an LED wall or something like that, go ahead, give me a like, subscribe, share, etc. And if you do subscribe, like the over 11,000 others who have subscribed to this channel, by all means, don't forget to click the little bell icon so that you get notifications about when I release this information. So, at my church, we've got an LED wall. Actually, we've got three or four, maybe five, depending on how you count. It's actually just how things are split up. But, all that to say, I was noticing the other day, because it used to be the case that if it went on the screen, I touched it. That's no longer the case. And we've got someone who does some background videos for songs, and I was thinking, I bet ProPresenter can do that. So, in order to show you how to do this, let's head over to the computer, and I'll show you just, it's a little time intensive, but if you need to change something, it's a lot faster once you've created this. So, let's head over to my computer, shall we? Okay. So this is the song that I'm doing this with, and first off, I wanted to show it to you so that you could see what's going on here. So if I click on this, notice how B dissolved in and gain, so a little bit more dynamic than maybe you're used to. And I did that with the second slide. So how did I do that?
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
Well, let's go into the editor and we'll tweak things. So I'm going to right click, edit slide here. And first off, I don't need that anymore. That was from a different tutorial. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this stuff on the shape here in this text box. I'm going to get rid of the fill, going to get rid of the stroke. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that the grid lines are enabled, so that is okay. Blanking just for a second here. Yeah, they're right there. Silly me. Okay, so I need theme guidelines to be showing here. So make sure, actually, slide guidelines, not theme guidelines. I can hide the theme guidelines. And the alignment guides are also going to be helpful, so make sure that that's all the case. First thing I want to do is I'm going to divide this into two lines. So I'm just going to click on that, hit enter, and then I'm going to do a little bit of formatting to make it a little bit better looking. So let's make he a little bit bigger here. Let's make me a little bit bigger. So what I'm doing here is I'm just basically adding emphasis to different parts. Maybe caused. Let's just make that bold. And pain. Let's change the capitalization to that, to all caps. Okay, so I've got that, but that doesn't enable me to automate or animate the individual pieces. In order to do that, I need to duplicate this once for every section that I want to do. So I'm going to do died, that's one. He, for me, is three. Who caused, four. And his pain, five. So let's right click and actually, I'm just going to do Command C on a Mac, Control C on Windows, and yep. So here's what I did wrong is I had the text inside of the text box ready to be edited, not the rest. So now having copied it, I'm going to paste it a couple more times. I said six. I said five. Let's do six. And this bottom one here, I'm going to make sure that's the one that I have selected. Okay. And then I'm going to click in here. And the first thing I'm going to do is basically undo one of the things that I did earlier when I got rid of that background. So let me fill that. And let's put this back. Oops, wrong one. Okay, notice how that this aligns and puts it smack dab in the center. That's good. So now I'm going to lock that so that I can't accidentally move it or anything. Okay, let's start at the very top in order. Get rid of everything other than died. Actually, let me go ahead and I'm just going to lock all the rest of these layers just so that I can't accidentally mess stuff up. Okay. So let's get rid of everything but died. That's nice and easy. And let's lock that and unlock the rest of it. For that, I said the rest, just this next text box. Actually, let me first align this because I forgot to do something. I forgot to drag down from here so that I can see where the different lines align, since I now have that aligned. Let me do the same thing here on the left, starting with the D. Let me hide those using this little eyeball here. Okay, add another one to align where who starts. Okay, so now I can get rid of died and everything other than who. I mean, other than he. Silly me. Okay, so now I have died he. Lock that, hide it, unhide, unlock. got dyed he done, so let's get... Get rid of dyed he. I could hide that dyed, leaving for me. And then I'm going to get rid of the rest of that. Now, again, hide that, lock it, unlock this one, unhide. Let's get rid of everything other than who caused. So, that's pretty easy. And then that. Hide that, lock it, unlock the next one down, unhide it, and get rid of everything other than his pain. Okay, so now if I show everything, I should see all of the words. Okay, now you see the reason why I didn't want to forget those lines is because I need to align some of this stuff. So let's start with this first one. Died. Okay, and now I can lock that again. Unlock this one. I can just drag that whole text box where I want it. And I'm just nudging it up with the arrow key. You might not have known that you could do that in ProPresenter, but you can. Lock that one. Then unlock the next one, which was for me. Died he for me. Let's lock that. And let's unlock who caused his pain, or who caused. And I'm just gonna drag that over. As I recall, it was the second one, so right there. Actually, I think I've got that reversed. So, let's do that. Lock that one. And then select his pain. Yeah. So let's lock those and unlock died he and for me. And then I'm just going to manually move those. Okay, so now if I go to show and click on it, that looks pretty good, except it all came in at once. So how do I solve that problem? Again, going back into edit, edit slide. Let's make sure that everything is unlocked. Unlocked, 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 and all showing. Yep, they're all showing. Now I can go into build here. Let me select this first one. And for For the first one, I'm going to add a build. Let's just do a simple dissolve and hide myself down here. Down here, instead of on click, let's do after transition and let's do like a half second. Okay, and let's repeat on this next one. Add build, dissolve, and all at once, that's all good. Not on click, after build one, and let's do, let's say, a third of a second. So make sure that you don't leave off the period there, the decimal point. Next one, let's do this one a little faster. Again, cross dissolve. Let's do this one 0.2 seconds. And who caused? Add a dissolve, not on click, after build 3, let's do half a second, 0.5, and let's do the last one, his pain. So, and dissolve. And let's get to that a little faster, so 0.2. Okay. Now notice I'm not doing anything down here with this because I want this to be there and then have the words come in afterwards. So that's why I've done that. So now if we go to show and then I do it again, died he. I made a mistake. I left this on click, hence the reason you see these down here, but right there. And I did the same thing for his pain. So I need to make sure that those come in not on click, but after the previous transition. So that's a change that I'll make. But that's basically how I did this and this. So that it's a little bit more dynamic in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free for that course. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.